The term stoichiometry refers to the amounts of chemicals used and produced in a chemical reaction. And the coefficients of a balanced chemical equation tell us that relationship. Now, when we look at a balanced chemical equation, we're used to thinking of these coefficients as number of molecules. So if we look at this balanced equation for the combustion or burning of propane, one molecule of propane requires 5 molecules of oxygen to form 3 molecules of carbon dioxide and 4 molecules of H2O. Number of molecules isn't very practical because we can't isolate 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or even 1,000. So in practicality, chemists look at these coefficients as moles because mole is also a number. So a chemist looks at this balanced chemical equation as 1 mole of propane reacts with 5 moles of oxygen to form 3 moles of carbon dioxide and 4 moles of water. This is an incredibly, incredibly important relationship between all the chemicals in this balanced chemical equation. Now, let's look at this relationship from a simple example, and then we'll look at a more complex example. If I had 2 moles of propane, how many moles of oxygen would I need? Twice as many, 10. And I would form 6 moles of carbon dioxide and 8 moles of water. If I had 3 moles of propane, I would require 15 moles of oxygen, 9 moles of carbon dioxide would form, and 12 moles of water would also form. So when the coefficients of propane are multiples of 1, then it's super easy to see the relationship, but sometimes it's a little bit more complex. So that is why we use what are known as mole ratios in stoichiometry. And what a mole ratio is, it is the ratio of 2 different chemicals from the balanced chemical equation, which includes their coefficients as well as the mole, to remind us that we're talking about moles. So here I have an example of 3 of the 12 possible mole ratios where water is in the denominator. So in this balanced chemical equation, 1 mole of propane will always form 4 moles of water. When 5 moles of oxygen react, 4 moles of water always form. And when 3 moles of carbon dioxide are formed, 4 moles of water are also formed. So these mole ratios allow us to figure out relationships between different chemicals in a balanced chemical equation. And so what do I mean by that? Let's look at this example. How many moles of oxygen are required to burn 2.33 moles of propane? So a typical stoichiometry problem asks us to convert from a given amount of one chemical and convert to an amount of a different chemical. And the relationship between these two chemicals, or the conversion factor from one chemical to the other, is the mole ratio from the balanced chemical equation. And that mole ratio will always have the chemical we're converting from in the denominator, the chemical we're converting to in the numerator, and the coefficients from the balanced chemical equation. So in this problem, we're converting from 2.33 moles of propane. So that's what we start with. My conversion factor is going to have moles of propane in the denominator because that's what I'm trying to cancel out. And propane, according to my balanced chemical equation, has a coefficient of 1. So 1 mole of propane goes in the denominator. I'm trying to get to moles of oxygen. So moles of oxygen goes in my numerator, and the coefficient of 5 comes from the balanced chemical equation. So I place a 5 there. So my units of moles of propane cancel out. I multiply 2.33 by 5, and I get 11.65 moles of oxygen.